Good morning. Welcome to Junior Church. We're glad you're here. We are going to be starting Christmas program practice. So our program this morning that's being recorded is not going to be very long. So we're going to start by singing Joy to the World. Josiah, can you get Joy to the World for us?
I want to help.
You want to help? Come on up. You want to help, Ken? Hayden, come on. Okay, just hold these up for us. Okay, the rest of us are going to sing. Who's ready for Christmas? Oh, Andrew is, of course. Okay, Chloe, we're ready.
You're here this morning and that you're feeling good to be here. Let's have prayer. Lord, we thank you for this day and for your blessings to us. We thank you for each and every one of the young people that are here today. And we thank you, Lord, for the extra hour last night with time change. We ask that you would strengthen us and help us in all that we do today for your glory and honor. Amen.
Okay. Where did we come from? Where did the world begin? Does anybody know? Does anybody know? Can you tell me, Zach?
What was it?
Where did the world come from?
God.
Do you know what the Bible says? In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. And so leading up to Christmas, we're going to talk about the beginning of the world and how sin entered. Long ago, the world was dark. Just like night. Chloe, you're going to have to help me. And there was no dry land, only deep, deep water all around. And God, who could do anything, he had a plan. He thought, I will make a world that will be just right for people to live in. But of course, there wasn't any people yet. But God was still planning. He didn't decide just to make a world because he needed to make it. He chose to make it. God is love, and he wanted to make something for someone else to let them know that he loved them. The first thing that God thought was, I must do something with all this darkness. How would you like to have darkness all the time? We wouldn't do well with the darkness, would we? And because of God's power, all he said was, and let there be light. And there was light in the world. God called the light daytime, and the darkness he called nighttime. And God knew there had to be daytime, so the children could go out and play. You couldn't go out and play in the dark all the time, could you?
Yeah.
No. You have to have light to go out and play. And it is good, said God, and he was pleased. So God made all this happen on the first day of creation. The second day, God separated the water from the land. So we need that green piece put on. He made a sky, and he made all that was in that. Okay, God knew when he made people, they would want a place to plant their trees and their flowers. And once again, God only had to say, let water be gathered together, so the dry land will appear. And it did. The water came together and made big oceans and seas and middle-sized lakes and rivers and little streams and puddles that little boys can go play in. Who likes to play in puddles? I think you do. Well, I have a puppy who got in a puddle last night. He was mud from head to toe. Even the puppies play in puddles. And now they're was land, enough land for cities and towns where people could live. And there is enough ground to make big mountains and little hills. And God called the land earth, and the water was seas. And it is good, said God, and he was pleased. And all this happened on the third day. The next thing God did was to make trees and plants. Did we have a tree? Did we forget the tree? All right, we'll just do the plants. Okay, and he made big colored flowers and gave green trees to give fruit and some tall leafy trees to make shady places on the ground. The fruits had seeds inside, so when they were planted, they would produce new plants. But there is still something missing in the sky. I know what I'll do, said God, and he put a big round sun in the sky. You were early, but the sun. So we have a sun in the sky and a silvery moon and twinkling stars to shine at night. And God looked at what he had done and he said, it is good. He was pleased. And this was the fourth day. Then he made a sky with fluffy white clouds. And there's our clouds. And a warm, bright sun. There were no birds in the sky. But down on the ground, there were oceans and lakes and rivers. But there were no fish to swim in the sea. So God created the fish and the birds. And God said, it is good. And next Sunday, we'll continue with how the world came into being. Because next Sunday, we'll learn how God made man. Okay. We're glad that you have joined us. If you've been watching online, you know how. We'll see you next week.